grow up to be true. May you always know the truth and see the light surrounding you. May you always be courageous, stand upright and be strong, and may you stay.
A sleepy golden storm is many love before us. I know that we are not new in city and in forest. They smiled like me and you, but now it's come to distances, and both of us must try. Your eyes are soft with sorrow. Hey, that's no way to say goodbye. I'm not looking for another as I wander in my time. Walk me to the corner, our steps will always rhyme. You know my love goes with you as your love stays with me. It's just the way it changes, like the shoreline and the sea. But let's not talk of love or chains and things we can't untie. Your eyes are soft with sorrow. Hey, that's no way to say goodbye. I loved you in morning, our kisses deep and warm, your head on the pillow like a sleepy golden storm. It's many love before us, I know that we are not new. In city and in forest they smiled like me and you. But let's not talk of love or chains and things we can't untie. Your eyes are soft with sorrow. Hey, that's no way to say goodbye.
May God bless and keep you always. May your wishes all come true. May you always do for others and let others do for you. May you build a ladder to the stars and climb on every rung, and may you stay. Thank you.
May your heart always be joyful. May your song always be sung. And may you stay.
Hello everyone, good afternoon po. I want to welcome you all to SEPA, a virtual celebration and send-off for a beloved member of our UP Baguio community. It's nice to see most of you. We do wish now we could see each other again in person very soon, but for now, we will make the most out of this virtual setup. Today, we will be paying tribute to, I guess, one of the humblest, most gracious, and brilliant professor and administrator there is at UP Baguio. She's none other than Professor and outgoing Vice Chancellor for Administration, Jessica Cariño. I am Raymond Intal, by the way, and I will be co-hosting this afternoon's program with Professor Gracial Miklay. Ma'am Gracial and I are from the Department of Anthropology, Sociology, and Psychology of the College of Social Sciences, where Ma'am Jess, or VC Jess, is also a part of. She is a professor of anthropology there.
All right, thank you, Raymond. May we ask everyone to keep their microphones muted while not currently speaking? So if you want to talk, kindly raise your virtual Zoom hand and we, the moderators, will call on you. So, okay, with that being said, may I call on our department chair, Dr. Jennifer Josef, or Ma'am JJ, to introduce our event and our guest of honor. Ma'am JJ?
Magandang hapon. Welcome sa ating talagang pinanindigan ng dalawang batang faculty namin na hindi banggitin ang title ng event. Bahala daw ako. So welcome sa Sëpi. Tama ba yan, Ma'am Jess? Ang Sëpi ay nangangahulugan ng to miss the presence of another. And indeed, we will miss very much yung quiet presence ni Ma'am Jess. Anyway, dahil pagod na pagod si Dean Toto, ako yung kakarga ng kanyang ilang mga tungkulin. Ito yung mala welcome remarks kasi ayaw ko naming i-spoil kung ano yung mangyayari ngayong hapon. So, very limited lang yung sasabihin kong bago natin umpisahan yung audiovisual presentation na ginawa namin. So, okay. Nandito tayo ngayon kasi hindi kayang hadlangan ng COVID, ng lockdown at ng gobyernong ito ang ating pagbibigay ng ating mga pagbati, magagandang mensahe at pagpapasalamat sa taong binibigyan natin ng parangal at paghahatid o send-off sa araw na ito. Ayaw kong pangunahan ng mga mensahe na mapapanood natin sa ilang sandali lamang mula ngayon. Gusto ko lang sabihin na marami ang nagmamahal at kumikilala sa husay mo, Ma'am Jessica Cariño. Pasensya na po sa technical glitches ng audiovisual presentation. Wala pa po kaming tulog. We're hoping na may himala. May last 2 minutes na hindi ma-render yung video. Pero we will continue editing and we will later upload a complete and higher resolution version of the AVP in the coming days in sa Facebook and YouTube channels ng UP Baguio. Sana magustuhan ni Ma'am Jess yung hinanda ng departamento para sa kanya ngayong hapong ito. So, panoorin na po natin ang mensahe mula sa mga nagmamahal at gumagalang kay VCA Jessica Cariño. Sir Kim, Don?
Hello everyone, good day to our colleagues at the College of Social Sciences, especially our colleagues at the Department of Anthropology, Sociology, and Psychology. I would like to take this opportunity to thank the chairperson of the ASP, Professor JJ, for giving me this opportunity to pay tribute to one of the most important persons in my life and in the life of the university. Wow, hindi ko maisip na magre-retire na o mawawala na sa UP Baguio si Jessica. Parang college pala ako, undergraduate yata ako eh. Nandyan na siya. She was my professor, or my teacher in history when I was in the undergraduate program of BASS, History and Political Science. And I remember her to be a very good teacher. She speaks with clarity. She's very articulate. She's a storyteller. When she starts teaching, everybody is in awe, even after the class. And she's one of the reasons why I decided to shift to history from being a BS biology student in the undergraduate. I also saw her becoming a division chair of the College of the Division of Social Sciences then, when we were still under UP Diliman. We were still a college of UP Diliman. And I've seen how she manages people well. She's a silent worker. You know? She may not be seen talking to everybody every day, but you know that she's always busy and working for the good, you know, of the division then and the college. And as a dean, you know, of the College of Social Sciences, I've also seen how she would bring together people to work for a common goal. She's a conflict management person, I would like to believe. I really learned a lot from her, especially when she became already our Vice Chancellor for Administration. And precisely that's the reason why I chose her as my our Vice Chancellor for Administration, because I know that she's loved, you know, by our administrative staff and faculty, of course, and reps. And I know that she listens to everybody, and she gives very fair advice to us, you know, as a team. Alam nyo, siguro hindi ko kinaya, no, yung buong siyam na taon na pagiging chancellor ng UP Baguio kung hindi dahil kay Jessica. Siya ang aking advisor, mother confessor. pag nagsalita na kasi si Jessica, makakalma ka, no? Maski na sa panahon ng turmoil, no, in the midst of turmoil or crisis in the university, her mere presence, no, is calming. Especially so if she starts talking and giving her her wise, no, advice. Kaya lahat kami sa team ay talaga nakikinig din, no, sa payo ni Jessica. Again, sinasabi ko, hindi yung siya masyado sigurong nakaka-interact, no? Pero siya ay isang tahimik, no, na nagtatrabaho at nagpo-produce, no, ng outputs, no, para sa ating pamantasan. Kaya hindi ko talaga ma-imagine ang university na wala si Jessica. Katulad ng iba't yung mga pioneers natin na nag-retire na, at yung mga pa-retire na rin, katulad ni Laurie Lee, no? Yung mga ito, yung generation talaga ng mahuhusay na faculty ng SOCSAI na magkakaling magturo pag marunong sa administration, no? At marami tayong natutunan sa kanila. Nakakalungkot na alis na siya, pero alam ko na tayo na naging mentee niya vicariously or directly ay ipagpapatuloy natin, no, yung magagandang traits at katangian ni Ma'am Jessica bilang isang professor at bilang isang faculty administrator. Jessica, I will miss you, you know that. Thank you very much for agreeing to serve again the university at a time when you told me at that time that you were on semi-retirement already, having served the university for so many years. But I begged for you to please help me, because I know that with you around me, I can do it, and I can do it very well. Thank you very much, and enjoy life beyond UP. Happy retirement.
With long days on the job, colleagues often become like a second family. When a coworker retires, we feel sad, but at the same time, we're happy because we will enjoy the fruits of her retirement. This is exactly how I feel for BCJS, a cherished colleague and a friend. We have worked together for almost a decade of professional friendship and collaboration. Being one of the pillars of UP Baguio, I trust her institutional memory, so I refer to her decisions I am not very confident about. She's always available and could be relied upon not just to provide feedback, but valuable and objective feedback right on time. Her insight and strength as a sounding board helped immensely, and I feel much more confident in being able to make the right decisions. In the various committees we sit in, she carefully listens to issues and is generous with her advice. She had the patience and wisdom of a mother, yet the spirit and gentle touch of a colleague, and in all this, her immense courtesy and concern for others are evident. Our conversations are sincere and helpful. She always listens carefully and responds thoughtfully. I envy her calm and reassuring presence. Thank you, VCKS, for your support and friendship. It is a privilege working with you. I would always remember you as a person of beauty, dignity, grace, and respect. Happy retirement, and I cherish our moments together while at work. Thank you.
Congratulations, Ma'am Jess, on your retirement. It has been a little more than 30 years ago when I first met you as a new faculty member, and you were then the chairperson of the Division of Social Sciences. And then after this, of course, I had several other opportunities to work with you. When you were dean, I became the division chair. And then, of course, more recently as MFA director and APFC member, you were, of course, the vice chancellor for administration. So I mention this because in all of this time, I had learned so much from you, especially in terms of being more collegial and giving respect to you know, different personalities when we work together. So in the SOC side, for instance, and of course we do have a lot of interesting personalities, it just amazes me so much how you are able to, let's say, call ideas, you know, from all of these long winding meetings and bring us back to focus when, you know, different voices become very loud. So I think that is something that I appreciate so much with you, you know, leading us back into consensus or some kind of an agreement eventually. So I salute you for your untiring work. I remember when you were dean, you used to go to Diliman. It must have been very difficult for you having to travel 6 hours, you know, pre-NLEX, SETEX, TPLEX. and then, of course, maybe the small and big issues that you had to face as BCA. And you were able to do them very well. So to meet this very well. So as we say farewell to you, I wish you all the best. Maybe in the future, when we are able to come back to campus, we will see you again joining the Zumba sessions. So for now, take care, and I really miss you. Thank you so much.
Hi, Ma'am Jess. I'm not sure if you remember that I applied twice in UP Baguio. First one was in 1994 when you were coordinator of the Social Sciences Division, and the second one was in 1996 when you were already the Dean of UP College Baguio. But my real interaction with you began when you became Vice Chancellor for Administration, and I was then the HR, and I became the HRDO Director Chief. Looking back at the 9 years that I have been with the outgoing administration, I don't think I would have made it to this day without your support. You have given the office a clear direction in terms of its mission. You have helped us through the challenges that we met in the discharge of our duties. And I would say that the staff of HRDO look up to you for guidance. Mom Jess, I learned much from you. From you, I understood the virtues of patience, understanding, compassion, and humility. I also learned to look at issues and challenges from a broader perspective. Thank you very much for all the support that you gave to the office. And thank you for understanding my shortcomings as head of the office. I wish you all the best. Thank you very much and God bless.
Amid the time I have worked for you, I have appreciated your leadership and been appreciative for everything you have taught me. In the event that I have learned anything from your leadership, it's to never stop challenging myself. The time you've invested in me has made me way better at what I do. It's truly been a joy learning and growing under your watch. Nevertheless, we know that there are numerous stages of life, and retirement is one of the greatest. Looking back at your career, you ought to be cheerful with a work well done. It's been an honor to be part of your group, and I thank you for taking me under your wing. My first impression of you was simply to be exceptionally unforgiving on us. It turned out to wear unforgiving on yourself by being persistent with employees like me. I will never forget that, ma'am. The conclusion of your professional life is the beginning of your retired life. It might take a few minutes to get used to it, but I can think of anybody who warrants a life of every relaxation more than you. We're all going to miss you, but know you are entitled to have the free time to do what you want to do. Congratulations on retiring. Sit back and enjoy. Sabi ni Sir Marsan noon, Mar, magsalita ka, ang masasabi ko lamang, mabait siya. Gawin mo ang trabaho mo. Yun po ang sinabi sa akin ni Sir Marsan, that it turned out, mabait nga si Ma'am Jess. Bye, ma'am!
I-recall ko lang yung mga memories ko with Ma'am Jess na nakasama ko siya sa Soksay hanggang sa Registrar's Office. Nung dumating si Ma'am Jess sa Social Sciences, dalaga pa siya. And then, meron siyang naging project noon sa Cagayan Valley, na parang displaced families yata yun. Kinuha niya akong clerk type piece sa project na yun. So, naging close kami noon sa mga panahon yun. And then, hanggang sa naramdaman ko na lang na family talaga ang turing niya sa akin. Maraming mga pagkakataon na nagkasama kami sa birthday ng mga anak niya, birthday ni na Carlo at Maria, sa Registrar's Office nung nagpa-party pa kami doon sa Carpentry Office. Tapos, nung naging division chair siya sa Social Sciences, nakita ko kung paano niya i-handle yung mga difficult situations very calmly na tinakil niya yung mga, hinandle niya yung mga situations yun. Mas matahimik lang siya, lalo na kung galit. Nung naging college secretary naman siya, nakita ko rin kung how she deals with problems inside the office. Kasi kami lang minsan nagkakaproblema eh. Problema ng mga estudyante at problema ng mga magulang na pumupunta sa kanya. Nakita ko lahat yun kung paano niya hinandle. As a dean naman, hindi ko makakalimutan yung may naging issue noon ng promotion ng mga admin. Alam mo na yun, Boss Jess, kung anong naging problema natin noon at paano natin yung hinandle. naiisip ko lang. Isa pang bonding moment namin, ko, bonding moment ko with Ma'am Jess, ay noong nagpunta kami sa Mangaldan, kasama namin si Ma'am G, kaming tatlo lang ang pumunta. Napakasaya nung moment na yon na magkakasama kami. At talagang hindi ko makakalimutan. Dahil for a while, kinalimutan ko siyang din. Ang turing ko sa kanya talaga noon, kaibigan lang. Hindi ko siya superior. After nung, tapos nag-study leave na siya for her doctoral, no? Tapos nung bumalik siya, siguro mga 2011 or 2012, bagong chance natin noon, si Chance RR. At masaya-masaya na lang kami sa admin dahil tinanggap niya yung pagiging PCA. At kung ilang terms si Chance, ganun din ang pinagsilbi niya as PCA. At alam namin na nating lahat kung paano niya tayo pinagsilbihan bilang PCA, ano? Marami akong mga pagkakataon na nakasama ko siya sa PFC, sa mga committee meetings. At nakita ko naman talaga kung paano niya i-handle yung mga situations, mga problema. At siyempre, hindi natin makakalimutan na isa siyang mabuting tao, isa siyang maka-Diyos. At sigit sa lahat, mahal na mahal niya tayo at mahal na mahal din natin siya. Happy retirement again!
I've had the privilege to work closely with Jessica for many years. During her time as Dean of UPCB, I headed the math discipline, the college extension program, and the task force on extension program. We were together in defending a major curricular revision of the BS math program in UP Diliman in the early 90s, and brainstormed in many college-wide meetings in preparation for our transition to a CU. Recently, we worked together for a course in the PhD in Indigenous Studies program. She was one of the reasons why I accepted the Vice Chancellorship, because I knew that I could work well with her. A relationship I would like to believe is based on mutual respect and trust, which is evident until now at the APFC, with me as a representative of the academic union and Jessica as co-chair of the committee, even if we don't agree all the time. I learned so much from Jessica, from her leadership style, her critical analysis of and principled stance on many issues that affect our constituents and our people. As a UP leader for many years, she's firm and objective, very unassuming and respectful, never a bully, especially to the staff and junior faculty, and does not push her weight around. Thank you, Jessica, for what you have done for UP Baguio and its constituents, and for playing a role in my own personal growth as a faculty and as an activist. It was an honor working with you then as the first EGROT leader of our institution, a pleasure working with you before your retirement, and I hope to be able to work with you still on issues we care about. You've been a great mentor and a friend, and I'm grateful. Stay strong and healthy, enjoy your retirement, and see you around.
Mom Jess was my instructor in Asian Civilization first year, first sem. And in Philippine History, freshly, second sem. My major then was BS Psych B-Med and then BS Biology when BS Psych B-Med was abolished. A couple more semesters made me realize that I was not suited to the medical sciences, especially when I accidentally discovered that the sight of blood literally makes my knees buckle. When I was deciding on a new major that was more suited to my inclinations, I remembered my two history courses under Mom Jess. That is part of the reason why I chose history as one of my double majors. I had teachers in grade school and high school who were Marcos fanatics who bombarded us with pro-Marcos propaganda. UP life was a culture shock and an eye-opener. I must say that my Philippine history class was one of the early influences in my political activism. Fast forward several years later, I was a young instructor at the Social Sciences Division of UP College, Baguio. During those days, the newest recruit is assigned as the DA secretary in charge of documenting and preparing the minutes of the division assembly meetings. It was my turn to be the DA sec when the Social Sciences Division was formulating and codifying its interdisciplinary trust. There were very long faculty meetings on interdisciplinary, multidisciplinary. I remember telling Mom Jess that I was overwhelmed by the discussions, briskly taking notes from the exchanges between the likes of Mom Lich Casambre, Steve Rude, Wayne Bokiren, Julius Mendoza, and the others. I admitted to Mom Jess that I had difficulty following some of the discussions during meetings and could not understand some of the memos submitted by some faculty members. I remember Mom Jess telling me, "Don't worry, JJ, don't worry too much." Sometimes I also do not understand some of the memos or letters sent to me by certain faculty members, even after reading them 3 times. Hearing that from her somehow eased my insecurities. More importantly, my takeaway from those exchanges is that it was okay to admit one's limitations and not to take oneself too seriously. She is unassuming in her demeanor. There are a lot of people who attempt to use 10 or 20 sentences when they can make their point with just 5 sentences. With Mom Jess, she only needs a few sentences to make her point. When she was the SOCSI coordinator, our faculty meetings did not take too long, mainly because of her preparation and her skills in facilitation. She's a woman of few words, but when she speaks, people listen. I believe that she's very mindful of how she deals with people, verbally or in terms of her actions, in order not to offend people. My guess is that she's aware that as a faculty and administrator, her actions can profoundly affect her students and coworkers. For me, her approach to dealing with people can be described as intuitive. I had limited dealings with her when she became an administrator, which was early in her career. I, together with other faculty members, did not always agree with the stand of the UP Baguio administration on many issues. But the disagreements were principled and respectful. That is why Ma'am Jess remains highly respected and well-loved by both the faculty and the non-teaching staff. During some of the most contentious issues that divided the CSS in recent years, I believe that she was among the stabilizing influences. When many were agitated and became very emotional in relation to certain issues, there was Ma'am Jess with her calm presence and voice of reason. In the confusion of all the noise during the difficult period of the CSS, I took my cue from her. In the brief period that I have been doing administrative work, she was there during crucial moments. Due to her busy schedule, she seldom attends our faculty meetings, but when she does, I have learned to expect that she had something important to say on important issues. She attends our department meetings when we or I make specific requests and tell her that we or I need her. She makes time to share her insights and lend her quiet support. On Jess, you did not need to be loud to be heard. You almost always made your point with your penetrating gaze, characteristically few words, unobtrusive presence, and for your quiet efficiency. This is bittersweet. We are sad because we will definitely miss you, but we are happy that you can now take it easy. Good luck and enjoy your retirement. Ma'am Jess, salamat pala dun sa libre mong chicken mami sa Vilmar's decades ago. Sana may pa-chicken mami ka ulit after this pandemic. See you around, Ma'am Jess.
Dear Jess, dumating na ang araw na pinakahihintay mo. Marami akong gustong sabihin, ngunit susubukan kong iklian ang aking pasasalamat sa iyo sa pamamagitan ng liham na ito. Liham ng pagunita sa 3 pinakamahalagang pagkakataon na ako ay natutumula sa iyo. Isa ka sa mga malalaking impluwensya sa akin at sa kung anong uri ng tao at mamamayan ng UP ako ngayon. Yung mga kahinaan ko, akin lang yon at wala kang kinalaman doon. Una, maraming salamat sa pagiging guro sa UP Baguio. Mapalad ako at naging teacher kita sa PHI noong freshman ako. Unang araw pa lang may group assignment na para mag-report sa susunod na meeting. At dahil hindi naman kami group 1, akala ng grupo ko ay sa susunod na meeting pa kami magre-report. Siyempre, mali kami. Lahat pala ay dapat mag-report, kaya 0 ang score namin. Dahil doon, natutunan ko ang kahulugan ng pagiging responsable at ipinagmamalaki ko ang grade ko na 2 sa klase mo. Hanggang ngayon, sinisikap ko bilang isang tao na maging responsable sa bawat araw na ako ay naglilingkod bilang guro sa UP Baguio. Pangalawa, salamat sa pagiging administrador sa UP Baguio. Administrador na kalmado at mapaggabay. Bilang coordinator ng Social Sciences Division at bilang dean ng UP Baguio, isa kang huwara ng pagiging kalmado at rasonable. Hindi ko maalalang nagalit ka, kaya sa iyong pamumuno, hindi ko naramdaman na may krisis dahil ang mga suliranin ay hinahanapan ng mga solusyon kahit limitado ang mga resources. Noong inappoint mo ako na SRO, lalo kong natutunan palawakin ang aking konsepto ng kagalingan at benepisyo upang maging akma sa buong UP Baguio at hindi lang yung limitado sa Soksay. Iba pala yung palalawakin mo ang konsepto mo ng interes na para sa buong UP Baguio at hindi lamang sa iyong sarili o sa iisang sektor o disiplina o sa kolehiyo. In short, lumalim ang pag-unawa ko sa organizational thinking na unang itinuro ni Dr. Casambre at Dr. Rude sa akin sa political science discipline. Ang isaalang-alang ang organisasyon sa mga personal na desisyon. Naniniwala pa rin ako dito, Jess, kahit parang minsan, pakiramdam ko nagiging outdated na yata ang pananaw na ito. Pangatlo, at higit sa lahat, maraming salamat sa tulong mo sa akin at sa aking kapatid na si Odie noong nasa gitna kami ng pangkalusugang krisis noong 1997. Ang buong pamilya ng UP Baguio ang tumulong sa akin noong magkaroon ng kidney failure ang aking bunsong kapatid na si Odie. Nag-fundraising ang Soksay, pasimuno si Lulay Hamada, sumalangit na ang kanyang kaluluwa, nag-ambag si Weng Bokeren, pinahiram ako ni Dr. Rude ng pera para sa transplant, na nung mapag-ipunan ko at babayaran na kapiraso lang ang tinanggap at i-pay forward ko na lang daw sa iba. Hindi ko pa nga alam kung ibig sabihin ng pay forward noon. At ano ang naging papel mo din, Jessica? December 1997, schedule ng transplant, wala kaming matirhan ng nanay ko sa Quezon City. Dahil wala naman kaming kakilala doon, noong kailangan naming mag-kidney transplant sa NKTI. Humiling ako kay Dean Jessica na patirahin kami ng nanay ko sa Balay UPCB noong mga panahong iyon. Hindi ako nagdalawang salita at pumayag agad si Dean Jessica. At noong lumabas ako ng ospital, sa Dean's room ako pinatulog ni Dean Jess. Imagine, pinatulog ako sa Dean's room. Do you know how much of a big deal that was for me at the time? Dito ko nakita ang pagkalinga ng UP Baguio at ang papel na ginagampanan ng mga leader nito. Hindi lamang routine administration, kundi humanistic. Mayroong pakikipagkapwa-tao. Parang simple na lang ang mga ganitong bagay kung titingnan ngayon sa dami ng resources at mga pribilehiyo ng faculty. Ngunit napakalaking bagay nito noon sa amin, sa akin, at hinding-hindi namin ito makakalimutan. Maraming salamat din, Jessica, mula sa aming buong pamilya, sa akin, mula sa aking kapatid na si Odie, na kahit nagbalik na siya sa pagdadialisis sa nakaraang 10 taon, ay kasama ko pa rin siya hanggang ngayon. At bilang pagtatapos, may panahon na matagal kang nawala, at noong bumalik ka, naalala mo ba nung sinabi kong, "Can I hug you?" And you said yes, and we hugged. I was so happy that you were back. Thinking, wow, maraming matututunan ang mga nakababatang faculty by simply listening to you speak and express your opinions. Ngayong magre-retire ka na, nalulungkot na naman ako, hindi sa pansariling dahilan, kundi dahil sa institutional na dahilan, sa mga araw sana na maaring matutunan namin sa iyo. Pero masaya ako para sa iyo at naiinggit siguro. Mula ngayon ay marami na ang oras mo para sa sarili at pamilya. Nakapag-ambag ka na ng malaki sa UP Baguio at dapat lang na may araw din ng pagpapahinga. Karapatan mo ito at karapat dapat ito sa iyo. Mula sa puso ko, maraming salamat sa iyo at sa iyong pamilya. Enjoy your retirement from UP. Lubos na gumagalang at nagpapasalamat. Toto.
Thank you for inviting Steve Rude and me to each contribute a message at this send-off surprise for Jessica. It is a privilege to be asked to participate in honoring a standout stalwart of UP Baguio. Having served in various administrative positions at UP Baguio over several decades, from 1986 to 2000 and 2012 to 2021, Jessica was an active participant and mover in UP Baguio's transformation from the little college on the hill to the vibrant autonomous university it has become. The interim between UP College Baguio under Diliman and an autonomous UP Baguio was in fact the time when Jessica led the college in daring to dream of a UP for Northern Luzon, chasing this dream down Marcos Highway to a promising new campus site. It was a necessary dream, a large part of the groundwork that included a college-wide strategic planning workshop circa 1997, Floor recalls, that prepared the UP Baguio community for the eventual realization of the autonomous university, expanding on the same hill that had been its home for six decades. My aged brain could offer only dulled memories of the decades from the 80s to 2000 when I left UP Baguio. Thinking back, the sense I keep coming up with for that period is the lack of drama, as in Jessica does not have a drama queen bone in her body. The proper word, of course, is equanimity. Jessica served and led with a calmness that I believe was rooted in a gift of multiple intelligence, keen understanding of duty and office, and sure-footed integrity. A couple of personal examples I recall. Two college graduations when I received a memo requesting me to write the dean's speech to introduce the graduation speaker. And one time I was called in to the dean's office to be consulted on a confidential matter. Done. No drama, just everyday official business. More recently, when the group of former faculty who had served in the 1960s under Dean Rolla planned to donate a gift to the college, it was Jessica that I quietly consulted and coordinated with to effect the donation. Congratulations, Jessica. Your generosity of self has contributed, indeed in no small way, to the thriving university and community that is UP Baguio. Today is a long stretch from that very first time I saw you. You stood just outside the back door of the house where I was a boarder, absorbed in a brief, hushed conversation. It was the day 49 years ago when the radio stations went uncharacteristically silent and life as we knew it was suddenly upended. It would be almost a decade later when our paths crossed again, this time as faculty colleagues. I had just come back to do my return service, Steve in tow, as a bonus to the college. Soon thereafter, I became a happy foot soldier for more than a decade under your able command. As a postscript, let me add, I wrote my textbook in unhurried and unheralded fashion after retirement. In my mind, I was engaged in a ritual of debriefing and putting a punctuation to the accumulation of syllabi and teaching notes over decades. Serendipitously, I had a complete draft just as my department was celebrating its centennial, a milestone I hadn't even been aware of, so I was happy to reveal my post-retirement project. you must have a book or two or more in you. I look forward to reading Jessica K. Cariño, author, in the years ahead.
Magandang hapon sa ating lahat. For my part, I'd just like to add a few bits about Jessica that I know. Back in 1985, the Division Academic Personnel Committee made a decision to grant her a study leave to finish her master's, and I always said that was one of the most productive decisions we had ever made, because besides her master's thesis, she produced a pair of twins. Very good. I never knew how she did it. A few years later, she wrote a working paper for the Cordillera Study Center called The 1991 Local Government Code and the Participation of People's Organizations and NGOs. And that working paper was taken up in Manila in something called, somewhat grandiosely, the Government Non-Government Coordinating Council on the Local Government Code. Because what they were trying to do is figure out how to encourage civil society participation in local governance and how to get local governments to accept it. The third thing I'd like to point out or remember is in 1994, I was offered a short-term consultancy by USAID to study the soundness of a proposed project to strengthen local governments throughout the entire country. I was a little worried, so I consulted Dean Jessica about whether or not I should take the offer, given that a number of people in the university might look askance at my taking U.S. money. And she said, "Oh, don't worry about it, Steve. It'll only be a few weeks. Nobody will notice." Well, as we all know, that was the beginning of a long trajectory that took me out of the academia and into the development. Finally ending up in 2017 when I stepped down from the Asia Foundation as its country representative. But at the beginning, in fact, I did learn skills in the Governance and Local Democracy Project, which allowed me and others to undertake technologies of participation as a study, as a form of facilitation for the strategic planning workshop that we did for UP Zone. So, there was some benefit to the UP as an academic institution. I very much enjoyed my time at UP Baguio, and Jessica was an important part of it. So I'm glad to be able to say Godspeed, Jessica. Best of luck.
Retiring after living the best years of your life to UP. Now you can build your house, exercise pa more, travel pa more. Cheers!
Hi Jess! After so many accomplishments and administrative details, welcome to world after UP Baguio with your family, pets, nature, and indigenous peoples in the Cordillera and globally. The whole world awaits you.
Hi, Jessica. I wish you a long, healthy, and happy retirement. Congratulations on your new job. Your new job is to ensure that you enjoy your retirement. Best wishes on your new beginning. I dare you to write your memoirs.
Congratulations, Jess, on your retirement after many fruitful years of serving UP Baguio. I'm sure your colleagues will miss your kind, wise, and calm leadership at the university. Now you can focus on reinventing yourself and finding something just as fulfilling and enjoyable to do with your time. You could become a baker, a travel blogger, a story writer, or all of the above, who knows? So happy retirement, Jess, and cheers from all of us.
Jessica, best wishes on your retirement from UP Baguio.
I guess after teaching and working for UP for more than 42 years, I can finally retire and rest, and hopefully we can start to build our retirement home. Good luck to both of us.
Hi, Ma. Watching you at work and at home while growing up, I couldn't have asked for a better role model in terms of work ethic, earning the respect of colleagues, staying calm and collected in the face of challenges, both work and personal, and maintaining a healthy work-life balance. You were always busy, but you were also always present for us. I hope I can one day be as good a role model to my children. That's it from me. I'm looking forward to spending more quality time with you now that you're retired, and I'll see you in a few days. Love you.
Okay. Hi, Ma. So I was invited to share this video for your send-off. Thank you to JJ and the other people who helped organize it. I think it's very sweet of them, and also shows just how much my mother's colleagues at UP Baguio have come to appreciate her time there and have enjoyed working with her. I myself spent a lot of time during my childhood, during my formative years in UP Baguio, running around, joining summer workshops, meeting the people that my mom worked with, and finally also getting to study there myself for a couple years in college. And so I have also grown to love UP Baguio very dearly. As has my mom, I'm sure, for having spent so many years there and giving so much of herself to the school. And that's something that I saw as a kid when she was the secretary, later as the acting dean, and then as the dean herself, through her presentations, her participation in things like the torch parade and Pasiklaban, which I still remember very well. And everything that happened since then, like more recently with the museum, which I think is amazing. So thank you again for putting this together. I'm looking forward to spending more time with my mother in Baguio as well, as soon as things let up. Hopefully that happens soon. And yeah, so I'm happy for you, Ma. And I'm glad that the people that you work with are doing this for you now.
Tell me,
dreams may be beautiful and yet much too painful to remember. We simply choose to forget. So it's the last.
To everyone who gave their messages in that AVB. And we'd also like to quickly thank the Dean of the College of Social Sciences, Dean Toto Colongon, for sharing with us his musical talents. He provided recordings of his rendition of Usahay earlier, and he also sang a song at the end of the AVB that was entitled The Way We Were. So thank you so much for the Toto.
Yes, those were very heartwarming messages. It's really a testament, Ma'am Jess, that so many people are going to miss you here in UP Baguio. Maybe there are also some other people who would like to say something. Perhaps you can start with Dr. Mendoza.
Okay, good afternoon, everyone. My internet is very unstable, so I had sent my file to Grisha just in case. So, PCA Jessica, let me begin by reading from a letter dated 2 February 1988. And it says, "How are your studies coming along? I can imagine how difficult this all is, what with a household to keep and two kids to care for. We are all cheering for you back here." These reassuring words were written by the coordinator of the Division of Social Sciences of UP College, Baguio. And yes, I kept a copy of that letter because the support and encouragement that those words conveyed have propped me up many times when my own resolve to complete my studies would nosedive. Then from 1998 to 2000, I served as director of the Cordillera Study Center. The Dean of UP College Baguio was my administrative supervisor. Together with members of the CSC board, she approved the proposals which I prepared for the transition of the Cordillera Study Center from its status as a research unit of the Division of Social Sciences into the Research Center of UP College, Baguio. This transition program was in consonance with the initiative begun by Dean Lazaro and which she continued to seek autonomy for UP College, Baguio. In those difficult years, as I learned the ropes of becoming an administrator, the dean provided me unflinching support and guidance. Of course, you know that my coordinator and my college dean is BCAA Jessica. That association began when she joined the faculty full-time in the early 1980s and continued until this year, 2021, when we both retire from government service. So VCA Jessica and I have worked alongside each other in different roles at UP Baguio for about 40 years. Thank you, VCA Jessica, for being a comforting presence in this workplace. If I find it too hard to use VCA Jess and instead keep calling her VCA Jessica, that's because our friendship has a longer history than the one we have at UP Baguio. BCA Jessica is a friend since 1968, or now 53 years. We attended and graduated from the same secondary school in Baguio City in 1972. And if not for the declaration of martial law that caused her to pursue her college education at UP Cebu, we would have graduated together in 1976. So when she approached me sometime in 2015 or 2016 to join her and several others to help organize an alumni homecoming for our high school classmates, I could not refuse her, even if I had avoided alumni reunions until then. But that alumni reunion turned out to be a most pleasant and memorable occasion. and for insisting that I join, I am deeply grateful. Thank you, Jessica, for being a friend. On behalf of Julius, with whom you served under Dean Pat Lazaro in the early 1990s, allow me to wish you joy as you embark on a new phase of your life and to wish you the best of what is yet to come. Thank you.
Thank you, Laurie Lee.
Thank you, Ma'am Laurie Lee. I also received a message here in the chat box, someone who would like to say also something to Ma'am Jess. Ma'am Karin.
Hello po, Ma'am Jess. You don't know me po. Bago lang po ako sa UP Baguio, but you might know my mom. She's here with me now and she has a message po for you.
Hi, Professor Jessica. How are you? I don't know if you still remember me, but I was one of your students in History 1, 1987, in UP Baguio. Yeah. Mm-hmm. So my daughter told me that there's a tribute for you today. So I came up with a recitation from your student who always sits at the last row of the classroom in the 2Os. Mm-hmm. I feel a great sense of privilege and blessing when my daughter informed me a tribute was scheduled for you today. They say great teachers create magnum opuses, but I am nowhere near a magnum opus. What I know is that your History 1 subject class, which I was part of in 1987, made the greatest impact in my worldview, convictions, and my life. It pulled down blinders from my eyes to see the e-growth, the Filipino in a new light, other than what history books painted me, the e-growth, the Filipino to be, in the context of the white man. This newly found pride fueled a positive ripple of impact later on in life when I started to raise my daughter, who is a cross between an Ibaloy and a Kankanae, and taught her how she could stand shoulder to shoulder equally with giants, even if their skin color is white. So that served her in good stead when she was qualified at the Sciences Po in Paris and studied there. So she had the same confidence with her white peers. So she was taught that no other race is superior than the others. This confidence, which then spiraled into a personal mission of influencing others to see their ethnicity, their roots, their race, their nationalities as distinct and not inferior from others, hovered over the growth of a girl who I see as one of your legacies, since you made so much impact in the life of her mother. It is with eyes of providence that I see now how symbolic it is that while you must have finished your mission to the next generation in the university, one of the fruits of your legacy comes into the fold of the academe to continue the mission of building great mindsets in the next generation. That is my hope. My daughter, the newly employed UP Baguio teacher, Karin Sharabangsoy, she doesn't want me to say this. I'm her mom, so I have to say it. Well, she's grateful for the chance to experience the journey. Abadag ja salamat sa sikam, Professor Jessica Cariño. This is Annabel Codiasi Bangsoy, our student seated on the last row, History 1, 1987 freshman UP Baguio. Thank you so much, teacher.
Thank you so much, ma'am.
Thank you.
Yes.
It's generational. Thank you. Thank you so much.
Thank you, Annabel. I remember you very well.
Thank you, teacher. Thank you. And enjoy your retirement, ma'am.
Thank you. Thank you.
Thank you, po. Maybe someone else also would like to go next. Ay, medyo nahihiya pa sila. So.
Si Raymond yata gusto
Raymond.
Thank you, po. Hi, Ma'am Jess. Hi. I just want to wish you a happy and healthy retirement. I also want to say that I want to thank you, and I feel so lucky that I was able to become your student at some point. Well, in a theory course 10 years ago for undergrad, and I would say that entering your class and attending your lectures would probably be the most peaceful and the most tranquil my adolescent brain ever was during that period. You know, because the adolescent brain can be turbulent, can have a lot of turmoil. And I feel like going to that class in the afternoon was a bit of solace for me. Mm-hmm. And I 100% attribute that to the way you handled the class, mm-hmm. and the way you handled yourself as our professor then. No, it just stuck to me how poised and how gracious you were as our professor. But at the same time, it was so palpable how dedicated you were to what you were doing, and your intellectual sharpness was so awesome to witness. So I'm very grateful that I had that opportunity to be in that class. And I feel like you were the one who taught me by example na in this profession, you can be honorable, you can be excellent, you can have high standards, but there's always room for compassion and kindness to your students or to people in general. I think I learned that from you, and that just stuck with me even now. And now that I'm also an educator, I always want to emulate you when I interact with students, when I try to understand where students are coming from. I really got that from you. So I'm very thankful na I was your student once, even just one class 10 years ago. It had such a huge impact on me.
Yeah.
Thank you so much, Paul.
Thank you, Raymond. Would someone else want to go next after Raymond? Maybe we can have one or two more before we go to the next segment of this event.
Ma'am Grayshell, how about you?
We were former students, of course, of Ma'am Jess, major in social anthropology. She was my Mom Jess was my thesis advisor in undergrad, and that's why I can categorically say that she is one of the most patient people I know, because that was a great time of turmoil in my life. It was such a struggle to write that thesis, so we really needed, even if I had a thesis partner, we really needed a very patient advisor, and we were grateful that we were given that patience, Mom Jess. Aside from being my undergrad thesis advisor, she was also, of course, our professor in social anthropology. And as a person who has always wanted to become a teacher since I was in elementary school, maybe because I was a teacher, my mom was also a teacher. In her class, I ended up thinking that if I was going to teach college, I was going to strive to be that brilliant. really, parang si Raymond din, that was like 10 years ago or more than 10 years ago. But it really made an impact in my life also. So thank you so much.
Thank you, Grayshell.
Okay, so parang wala na akong nakikita.
May hi, Grayshell.
Sure po, ma'am.
Hi, G.
Hi, BC. happy retirement.
Thank you.
Siyempre, I'm gonna miss you because not everybody knows that before the pandemic, I'm usually in your office in the morning.
Yes.
If I'm not with the BCAA office, then sometimes, you know, I go from the BCAA's office to the BCA office just for small talk. And I first served with Jessica when she was dean. I was her secretary. She's the most chill person I know. Kasi never ko siya nakita na, you know, even in the back, she doesn't lose her cool. She's always chill. She's always cool, calm. And so, syempre, sometimes at work, if you do have things to settle and so on, then one of the people that I usually go to would be, of course, VC Jess. VC, I'm really glad it's you.
I miss you. Thank you.
Okay, I think we also saw Professor Balmoris raise her hand. So maybe she can go next. And then after that, Professor Javier also has something to say to Ma'am Jess.
Good afternoon, VC Jess.
Hi, D.
I have had only a few occasions to work with Ma'am Jess in the past. And one of those was when we were tasked to explore for expansion sites for UP Baguio many, many years ago, since UP Baguio, UP College Baguio then was transitioning to make a more, well, was poised to make a more prominent role in the academe. So after a day's field work with then Professor Teo Macabiog, after VC Jessica has given us that assignment, I entered the then UPCB Dean's office and saw Dean Jessica surrounded by heaps of papers. So I thought to myself, I think this is a fire hazard place. And I asked, why would anyone want to behold in such an office? And it would take many years for me to arrive at the answer. It was service. So my encounters with Ma'am Jess was in her service as college dean in the 1990s and early 2000s, as facilitator of meetings. What helpful tips at facilitating meetings she offered without her even knowing it. So much has changed since, and UP Baguio would not have reached its stature without the contributions of Ma'am Jess, as many had earlier mentioned already. So it was indeed a privilege and opportunity to have worked with Vice Chancellor Jessica in the last 3 years in the executive staff. Thank you for being my model of calm composure, compassion, and ever incisive insights. And what rich institutional memory. Thank goodness you are just within reach. We will miss your presence in UP Baguio. On behalf of the College of Science, we wish you all the best in your next adventure. Maraming salamat.
Thank you, Dean D.
Salamat po, Dean. May we call on Ma'am Roselle next?
Okay. Sana naririnig po. Ma'am Jess, happy retirement po.
Hi, Roselle.
Yun po. Maiksi lang pong message. Maiksi lang. Hindi po. Naalala ko po yung una ko. Hindi ko po kayo naging guro. Pero yung nung nag-apply po ako sa UP Baguio noong 1997, kayo po yung dean at that time. And first, parang yun yung first time yata nakasama ko kayo sa isang room, I think. And hindi ko alam kung ano yung expectation. But I remember po, of course, you asked some questions then, but I can't remember anymore. Yung mas recent ko pong memory sa inyo, and I want to tell you that I think that was Christmas 2017 or 2018. May binigay po kayo sa aking little gift for Christmas. And I want to tell you that I kept po the tag. Binigay po kayo sa aming tag. I don't know if you remember what you wrote here, but I want to tell you that it was so important kasi na-feel ko po yung pagiging sensitive nyo at the time. You actually, and at the same time, my sense of humor po. Kasi in your message, you told me, Dear Roselle, God bless you for your steadfastness in the force of adversity, you said. And then you said, ha, 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 Jessica. So, when you gave me this, ma'am, more than the gift, I really treasured this. Kaya po kanina nung may opportunity to give a message, kinalkal ko agad sa bag ko. Kasi nakatago po ito dun sa aking isang lumang wallet. As reminder po, pag pinanghihinaan ng loob. And so, maraming salamat po, Ma'am Jess. Isang napakagandang alaala. Happy retirement po. Mag-ingat po kayo palagi.
Thank you. Thank you, Roselle.
Sorry na kami pala ako. Sana po yung mga tao na meron ding sasabihin kay Ma'am Jess, sabihin niyo po sa kanya in person. I'm sure she will appreciate that. So let us call on our department chair, Ma'am JJ, again for the next segment of our event.
Magandang hapon ulit. Ma'am Jess, nandyan po ba ang inyong butihing asawa?
Yan, nandito.
Minessage ko po siya sa messenger kasi kailangan ko ng tulong niya sa part na ito.
Ah, ganun.
Bago po namin kunin yung response nyo, meron po kaming munting regalo sa inyo galing sa mga faculty ng Departamento ng Anthropologiya, Sociologiya, at Psikolohiya. Nagtulong-tulong po kami para meron kaming makabuluhang gift na ibibigay sa inyo. Andyan ba si Sir Myong?
Yeah, sandali ah.
Habang wala sila, Gracielle, magpapasalamat na ba ako?
Tawagin ko lang ha.
Apo, thank you.
Sige po, ma'am.
Magpapasalamat na ako. Oo, kasi para mamaya baka magkalimutan na. Gusto lang po namin sabihin sa DASPI, sa Departamento ng Anthropology, Sociology, and Psychology, this event would not have been possible without the help of many people. We would like to thank Dean Jimmy Fong for helping us come up with the title, Sëpi. Dean Toto Kolongan for letting us use his vintage recording and for all the support.
We help Ipsupsups.
So that we can mount this event. Prof. Ikin Salvador Amores for the poster design. And in helping us come up with the gift. Ayan na si Ma'am Jess, sandali lang.
Nandito na si Myong.
Opo, salamat sir. Yung pong regalo namin, maraming salamat kay Roland Bayan for allowing us to use one of his paintings for the poster. And for giving us a huge discount. Si Professor Rutindan and Olive Mendoza, salamat sa mga Cariños, sa pamilya ng Cariño Cleto. Nais ko na ulitin ng aming taus-pusong pasasalamat sa iyong Ma'am Jess. Mahal ka namin ng buong UP Baguio. See you around. Sana makita ka pa rin namin. Godspeed at yan ay pandagdag sa inyong soon-to-be-built retirement home.
Yeah.
Hindi pa po tapos ha. Meron pa tayong ilang segments ng program. Pero gusto naming ipagyabang yung regalo ng departamento kay Ma'am Jess.
Yeah. Gustan natin. Wow! Ang ganda naman nito. Okay, thank you. Beautiful. Mainit. I will always treasure this.
Mainit-init pa po yan.
Bago. Ang ganda. Oo nga, 2021 talaga. Wow. Ginawa beautiful, po, thank you.
Ginawa po niya yan dahil at alam niyang para sa inyo siya. Yung painting na yan. Salamat, Ikin.
Yeah. Thank you. Beautiful.
Sana po nagustuhan niyo, ma'am. We would also like to hear from you, ma'am. Do you have something to say?
Yeah. Well, this send-off is really very heartwarming. I'd really like to thank the organizers. And it was, it brought back so many memories, you know, to me, and really affirmed what I've always felt, that I had the most productive and fulfilling career at UP Baguio. It gave me the chance to engage with many colleagues and students. And it gave me the opportunity to see many of you grow. And it's really very fulfilling for me. I'd like to thank some people who are very important in my career at UP Baguio. Let me start by thanking my seniors who served as my mentors. No? I remember when we were engaged in a visioning exercise to define the type of social science that we wanted to do I really learned so much from Lij, Steve, thank you very much. Lulay, Lorelee, Weng, thank you very much. Of course, some who have gone before us, Jules also, Jules, Carol, they helped to define what type of social science UP Baguio wanted to engage in. No? And I was a young faculty then, and although I presided in some of the workshops to arrive at this vision, I learned so much from that exchange of views. And then, of course, those who served as my mentors in administrative work, people like, you know, of course, Dean Lazaro, he picked me up from, he picked me out from among the faculty of the social sciences and gave me all kinds of work, which trained me in administrative work. And of course, those who stood by me as I was doing these assignments, people like Flor Hernandez. Thank you. G, of course, you've always been there. And many others, no, who were there and whom I look up to as, you know, among my mentors. Then I'm surprised that so many of you were actually my students when I was a young teacher, no? And you now occupy very important positions in the university. Of course, RR, people like RR, Willie Alanggi, Dean Toto, others who were also my students. Yun nga si Annabelle, she was my student in history, Leia, Jimmy Fong, all of you who were my students. And I'm so happy that I have seen you grow and become very important members also of the UP Baguio community. Then I think I would also like to mention that the administrative personnel have been a very important part of my career at UP Baguio. And I have learned so much from them, no? Because they have engaged in the paperwork which would otherwise have burdened the faculty. So I thank especially those who were who worked directly with me in the various positions that I occupied. So Manang Pen, I'm so happy to see you. And then, of course, there's so many of them, no? When I was in the Soksay, Manang Pen and a few others. Then when I moved to the secretary's office, of course, sina Manang Nani, Violi, Julie, and those who took over them, sina Ami, ganyan. Then when I went to the dean's office, of course, nandiyan sina Remy, Sophie, Emma Tarlit, Manong Perry, thank you very much. And then when I came to the Vice Chancellor's office, of course, Mar, Seg, Maggie, Darlene, Glo for a while. Thank you for all your support. And, you know, sometimes maybe the administrative staff feel that it can be a thankless job, but many of the faculty, of course, recognize the contributions that you make. UP Baguio will not be where it is now without you, no? And then I'm very happy that we have a new, a younger set of faculty now who are coming in and who are getting trained in the ways of the university. No, I'm happy to see the likes of Raymond, Grayshell, and all the other young faculty who have been working so hard, no? Sina Kelly, the people from philosophy and history, all of you, you are going to be the future of UP Baguio. And of course, I'm very happy that I have had a supportive family so that now that I'm leaving the university, I feel that, you know, I won't really be lacking in things to do because my family will be there. And they will keep me busy. Yeah, right. You know, I didn't realize that after all of these years, and we have come to this point, no? While you have mentioned that I have played a big part in making UP Baguio what it is today, I'd like to say that everything was really a collective effort. The discussions, brainstorming workshops that we had when I was dean, no, and before I became dean, all of this, this is what we put together into a vision for a UP Baguio, the University of the Philippines in this part of the country. So it has the inputs of so many of you, so many of us. And I'm just so happy that to this day, every day, I see that vision coming true, even up to now, in the new curricular programs that we are developing, in the new infrastructure that we have set up. Actually, this is like, I'm so happy that my dream is coming true. My dream for UP is coming true. And I retire with hardly any regrets. Of course, we all have regrets. We could have done better maybe. But I have hardly any regrets because we worked well together, all of us. And I know that we will be leaving this university to very capable hands, to the new leaders of this university. And I would like to say that there's something very special about UP Baguio. It's greater than any of us individually. And UP Baguio has, you know, it has something unique in it. And I feel that that is our concern for each other, how we pick each other up, how we support each other. And I will say to the young faculty now who will be taking over that you have joined a most honorable and an excellent faculty. And I'm sure that you will also accomplish great things. I thank you. It's been a most fulfilling, 42 years with the University of the Philippines. It's been the best. Thank you. Yeah, that's all.
Salamat po ng marami, Ma'am Jess. We would like also to thank you, okay, by offering you this toast. Pwede pong pa-prepare natin yung ating mga inumin. So, gusto po namin i-end itong event natin na to for Ma'am Jess with a toast. So, yung community toast po na ito is meant to be a symbolic gesture of our celebration. So we envision today not only as a way of expressing to Ma'am Jess that we will miss her a lot, but at the same time that we would like to thank her and we would like to celebrate the moments of her time that she shared with us as a colleague, as a friend, as a leader, as a mentor. So I would like you all to I would like to invite you all to raise your glasses for mga baso po natin. O ating mga bote. Yan, yan. Cheers po to you, Ma'am Jess.
Yeah. Marami thank you. Cheers. Cheers to everyone. Cheers.
Cheers. Galing din po pala sa DASPI yung say transgender, or they really have a category in terms of their orientation. Okay, so
yes, ma'am.
Sorry po, parang may nagsasalita kanina.
Can we have po a group photo through Zoom? Sino ang pwede mag-lead sa atin to strike a pose?
Yeah.
It's down.
Okay, pa-on po ng cam ninyo and we will print screen this. Ngiti lang po tayo kasi hindi ko alam kung anasang page na yung ipiprint screen natin. One, two, three, smile. Okay po. Next stage. Wait, sorry po. Mabagal yung aking computer. Baka Raymond, you can help me with the next page kasi naglalag yung computer ko.
Okay, sige. I'll do it from the top na lang. No. Okay, sige. Hold your smiles and poses in 1, 2, 3. And then, wait lang po. Then I turn the page from Rachel.
Yes, sir. Yes, sir. Next page.
Okay, sige, wait lang. Sorry po. Okay, next page. Ayan. In 1, 2, 3, smile. Okay, do we have a third page?
Yes.
Okay. So, third page na po tayo. 1, 2, 3, smile. Yeah. Okay. I think that's it po. Yeah. So, nakuna naman na po lahat. All right.
Ayun na, si Ruth, ngayon ka lang nag-on ng camera?
Okay, to close this virtual celebration and send off, can we hear once again from our department chair, Ma'am JJ?
Ako ulit. Ilang maraming salamat sa lahat ng tumulong para mabuo nito natin yung event na ito. Virtual man would have wanted na face-to-face para mayakap natin si Ma'am Jess. Pero maganda rin na hindi nakita yung mga medyo naluluha kanina habang nagbibigay ng testimonies yung mga tao. Mula sa departamento at sa kolehiyo at sa siguro sa lahat ng taga-UP Baguio, Ma'am Jess, maraming salamat. Naging inspirasyon ka sa marami sa amin. Kahit hindi ka aware na meron kang ganun palang effect sa mga tao sa paligid mo. Iyon siguro yung maganda eh, hindi ka aware, hindi contrite yung pakikitungo mo sa amin. At maraming salamat dun sa lahat ng tumulong para mabuo ito, yung mga bagong faculty, yung mga batang faculty ng Soksay, at saka yung mga thunders na rin ng Soksay. Sabi nga ni Ma'am Jess, kayo yung next generation, kaya ngayon palang Rachel, sabi ko, kahit 10 years pa kami magre-retire, maghanda na kayo. Paghandaan nyo na yung 10 years from now. So ulit, maraming salamat sa lahat ng tumulong, nakinig, nanood, sumuporta. Pwede pa po tayo magchikahan. I'm sure marami kayo tayong mga ngayon lang ulit nakita. Hindi po natin muna papatayin itong meeting na ito kasi ang hanggang 6 o'clock yata ang sinet natin. So yung mga gusto pong magkumustahan, sina Ma'am Lidge, sina Sir Steve, pwede pa po. Pero yung formal event natin ay sinasarado na po natin. Maraming salamat. Ma'am Jess. Thank you.
Bye.
Bye.
I'll see you.
Yeah, see you, G. See you. Nars, thank you for being around.
Oh,
Nars, thank you.
Thank you, Dean Jess.
Yeah, thank you. Nice to see you. Thank you, Doris.
Why does Toto look distinguished and I don't?
What's that? I look distinguished? This is my Casambre hair.
Oh, oh God.
That's right.
To see you, Dr. Rude and Ma'am Casambre.
Yes. Yeah.
It's good to see all of you.
We haven't seen Pat on time. There she is.
Yeah. And
Vicky.
Paige, Sir Steve. Kumusta po?
Hi, Tala. Vicky, Lelet.
Oh, Tala. Now we can see you. Kanina, you are done. I'm,
yeah. Manang pen.
Ay, hindi ko alam kasi on.
Oh, Jenny, where is she? Where is
there,
she?
There. Yeah.
Hi, Jenny.
Naka mask on.
Yeah.
Mom Liz.
Hi, Jen.
Hi, Mom Liz. Sir Steve, hi. Good to see you.
Galin mo daw yung mask mo kahit sandali lang. Huwag kang huminga.
Hi!
Si Ma'am Jess.
Hello, Ma'am Jess.
Bye, Ma'am Jess. Thank you, Ma'am Jess. Bye. Bye. Thank you, Lele. Bye-bye. Hi, Ma'am Lij. Dr. Rude. Bye-bye.
Bye.
Bye. Bye.
Salamat, Ma'am Lij.
May you always be courageous. Stand upright and be strong, and may you stay. Forever young. Forever young. Forever young. May you stay. Forever. Busy. May your feet always be swift. May you have a strong foundation when the winds of change shift. May your heart always be joyful. May your song always be sung. And may you stay. Thank you.